In the first debate for Tennessee's Senate race, both candidates distanced themselves from President Trump's trade war with China, calling for open markets to strengthen ties with allies. Bredesen commented on Memphis's crumbling infrastructure, while Blackburn pointed out the need for better background checks when buying guns.
Parts of our state, Memphis comes to mind immediately, where that are very dependent on that infrastructure, things like roads and bridges and rail, and are really suffering.
Putting the mental health into the NICS system, hardening our schools. And I have supported the School Safety Act. I've supported legislation that would make the red flags on mental health.
The two are running for the seat currently held by Bob Corker. All right, Councilman, you saw the highlights. Who do you think won?
Well, I don't think there were a lot of surprises in the debate. Both of them kind of made their points that you'd expect from a Republican and a conservative Democrat in the state of Tennessee. The biggest surprise to me was Bredesen's statement that he wouldn't vote for Schumer to be the leader. And I think that's because that's an attack that has been landing.
So that was a self-defense.
I think it's self-defense, and Congresswoman Blackburn should probably stay on that and say, well, would you vote for any leadership that would put Claire McCaskill as head of Homeland Security, or Bernie Sanders as head of budget, or Dianne Feinstein as head of judiciary, and stay on them, because that's the conversation from the national perspective that's really doing damage to the Bredesen campaign, and she shouldn't let that go.
And Matt, do you think that this, it's almost a race of guilt by association? They're trying to brand Bredesen with Schumer and Nancy Pelosi. Do you think that's a tactic that will end up working for Marsha Blackburn?
Oh, no doubt it's a tactic that they'll keep trying to make work. But there's already been $40 million of money outside Tennessee coming into Tennessee, trying to tell Tennesseans that a guy that served as 8 years as your governor from Tennessee and a Tennessean is somehow got more in common with Chuck Schumer in New York or Nancy Pelosi in California than he does with Tennesseans. And as you can see from a statement that he made last night, that was made in Lebanon, Tennessee, by the way, and the only other Senate race or the Senate debate is in Knoxville, Tennessee. We've yet to have one, and we aren't going to have one in Memphis or West Tennessee. I think that's a shame. But Bredesen's talked about the crumbling infrastructure in Memphis and in West Tennessee, and I think Tennesseans want a senator that knows them and is going to do something to help them.
Let's go ahead, and as long as you're here as our political consultant, let's touch on this. If Bredesen can brand Blackburn as being that Washington insider, and he's trying to do that with his campaign, air Blackburn, she's flying all across the country, is that a winning strategy for him on the other side?
Well, he's been in Tennessee the whole time. She's been in Washington. They're supposed to drain the swamp. She is the swamp, right? She's been the person that I like to say that the person that caught the bus, the dog that caught the bus, because she's in Washington, and now she's trying to say that she's better served to be the senator because she's been there. Well, I think people from Tennessee are going to think that you're part of the problem.
Terry, what do you see as Blackburn's ace in the hole? What's her strongest asset in this race to try to defeat a popular former governor?
Well, one is her relationship with the president. Whether people don't like to admit it or not, we're in a red state. I think it was interesting, Bredesen bringing up the infrastructure. Heck, he was the governor for 8 years. He didn't do a damn thing about it then. So, I mean, that's kind of, but Worth has got he touched on it a while ago. And something that you really hadn't brought up that's been happening this week is the deal with Kavanaugh. They've been acting such a fool. They have took that man and drug him through the mud for nothing. Absolutely. They keep calling for an FBI investigation. Heck, they done six of them. What else it's a stall tactic. They went in and they're so petty that they went into his yearbook and wanted to know what this meant and what that meant. Let me ask you something. Do you know what all you got written in your yearbook?
I don't know. I haven't looked at it in quite a while.
That's the point I'm trying to make. Yeah. That's petty, right? The lady, my heart goes out to her. She probably did have something wrong, happened to her, something bad. But she has no proof. No proof. And in this country, you're supposed to be innocent until proven guilty. not guilty, and you got to prove your innocence.
Well, and do you think that is going to have an impact on the Tennessee race?
Tremendously.
Yeah, it depends, because we don't know how it's going to play out yet. You know, so there was a vote on Friday to move forward with a vote next week in front of the full Senate. And this is an evolving issue. I mean, this completely changed on Thursday with the hearings and the back and forth and just bringing to light some of the actions, I think, by Senator Feinstein's staff and how this was leaked. And this could have been handled a long time ago, and probably Christine Ford's identity could have been kept secret. There could have been an investigation before we got to this point, and they tried to run the clock out. I think this is gonna be a problem for Democrats if it continues to be in the media. There are people fired up. There were some neutral Republicans, some independents I talked to yesterday after watching all the hearings, and they were writing people's names down. They were gonna write letters to senators, and these are reasonable people that don't necessarily put themselves in politics that often. I mean, it was there is definitely some motivating factors for Republicans to hold the line in Tennessee in November because of this.
Well, it kind of depends on what happens. I mean, I'm kind of putting on my political hat here. If Kavanaugh gets confirmed and he goes and takes a seat on the Supreme Court, from a, you know, political standpoint, and something that I wouldn't like to see, and you know, I think I'd be disappointed. But the other side of that is that if they do, or if they are successful in knocking him out of the nomination, and he is not going to be considered, and he won't get his vote, and we won't get on there.
Right.
I think that will anger Republicans, and I think that will probably turn out Republicans
and
more so
and energize that base.
Right. Whereas if he gets confirmed this week or next,
right,
and it goes through, I think you'll see Republicans kind of say, oh, yeah, well,
all right,
that's just...
Still a lot of moving parts here.
Yeah.
All right.
A lot of factors that could play into the election. When we come back, President Trump is bringing his campaign rally to the Mid-South, where he'll be and who he's here to support, coming up next on Informed Sources.